Good morning, and welcome to a word of encouragement from Fairbluff Baptist Church. The word of encouragement today is Phase 2, beginning tomorrow at 5 p.m. North Carolina is transitioning to Phase 2 with the coronavirus guidelines. And that means that we will also transition to Phase 2 with our devotionals. We started off by sheltering in place with a daily dose of love from Fairbluff Baptist Church. When we went into Phase 1, we transitioned to a word of encouragement from Fairbluff Baptist Church. And now that we'll be heading into Phase 2, beginning next week, we will do a weekly dose of prayer each Wednesday for our devotional. And then, of course, we will continue to post our worship services on our church's Facebook page and on the website page. So after today, we'll be doing Wednesdays and Sundays. So for our final word of encouragement, I wanted to share from you another stress reducer, because these are stressful days, even in Phase 2. We still need to be careful, practice social distancing, use our mask, use good common sense, continue to wash our hands. But our word for you today is going to come from the ABCs of Reducing Stress, and our letter today is the letter C, Copy Important Papers, based on Exodus 32:19. When Moses approached the camp and saw the calf and the dancing, his anger burned, and he threw the tablets out of his hands, breaking them to pieces at the foot of the mountain. Permit me to read from the devotional. When Moses saw what the children of Israel were doing, he became so angry that he literally broke the tablets containing the Ten Commandments that God himself had just written and placed in his hands. Now, can you imagine the stress involved in weaseling back to God and asking him to do it all over again? Just think what relief Moses would have felt in this situation if he had simply made a copy of those Ten Commandments before he broke them at the foot of the mountain. So the rule of thumb should be, if a document is important personally, financially, or legally, make and keep a copy for your records. I have a personal copier that I basically use almost every day and have been doing so for years. Now, here are a few simple tips. Make a copy of your driver's license, credit cards, prescription medicines, insurance policy information, etc., and store the copies in a safety deposit box or some other safe place. And if you're the caregiver for a parent or a sibling or someone else, you keep a copy of their medications, your power of attorney, and always the health care power of attorney, because that is critical in the event of an emergency, and keep those things with you at all times. Now, a simple 3-ring notebook with clear sleeves is an excellent way to keep up with these things. And remember, a little preventative paperwork today can go a long way in reducing stress. Now, I had a conversation with my son Matthew yesterday, and he kind of was laughing a little bit about me doing the devotional on writing it down. He said, "Mama, do you know how long it has been since I've put a note on a piece of paper or in a notebook?" He said, "I just always keep everything in my phone." Well, let me tell you something, those of you that are under 60, y'all go ahead and keep things on your phone if you want to. But if you ever lose your phone or your phone gets stolen, you are what we call up the creek without a paddle. So I'm going to stick with making a paper copy of things, because a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush, if you understand what I'm saying here. So if you want to take pictures of things and keep them on your phone, that would be one good way of doing it. But make sure that you have a backup somewhere if you want to reduce stress. So remember, when in doubt, make copies of important papers. I hope that you are blessed beyond measure today so that you can be a blessing. And I look forward to seeing you at worship on Sunday and then next Wednesday for a weekly dose of prayer. Bye now.